And we will continue to talk about our wins, if, for example, an end to new offshore oil and gas permits and exploration. You would only get that when there is the Green Party in government, and it's inevitable that the Prime Minister may announce some of our wins. That's just us working together. Mm. Similarly with New Zealand First, we're working together to achieve the billion trees, and many of them now going to be natives, working on regional, provincial growth and the regional rail. So we're working together for a lot of things that will have a real impact for New Zealanders' lives.
Talking up the wins. All right, the panel is back with me now. Jennifer, there is a tension there, isn't there? It's just sort of bubbling away, but they made a reasonable fist of it this weekend, didn't they?
Yeah, I think it's new ground for them, right? Because this is the first time they've been in government. The polls are saying they're sitting on 6%. That's holding their own from the election where they were on 6.3. So you would assume that they can only really build from here. So I think they'd be quite happy. Like, I mean, 12 months, it's not even 12 months really. There are some wins on the board, and yes, the current government, the Prime Minister might be claiming some of them, but they've held some really potential big ones back that they will be able to own, particularly around zero carbon.
Marama, you've been there as a minor party in a coalition type sort of arrangement. What's your feeling? How do you think they are going? It is tough at times, isn't it?
Oh, it definitely is tough, and you do find yourself making compromises. But what I don't understand with the Greens is that they have a confidence and supply arrangement where they have agreed to disagree clause, which essentially gives them the right to vote against anything they like, but they haven't. They voted with the government. Now, they may have agreed which things they would vote with the government on right at the beginning, but if you have an agree to disagree clause, that gives you independent voice. And what I've seen is that independent voice has been shut down. And you only have to look at Eugenie Sage selling off water rights to foreign ownership in Whakatane, and yet we have Marama Davidson talking about how wonderful it is to be in there, not
well, that
to sell
this weekend
water.
Was clearly an attempt, wasn't it, Maxine, to fix that, wasn't it?
Well, yes, I think. And what they've now done is extracted from their senior partner, extracted from the government, the fact that they will, in fact, look at that law so that Eugenie Sage wouldn't find herself in that same situation again. Speaking of Eugenie, I think that the announcement that she made today about the waste minimisation reported negatively as we might be paying more to dump waste could have just as easily been reported as Greens announced mechanism to deal with the burgeoning problem of waste now that China has closed its doors to the world's rubbish.
Yeah, but the reality is your average family could in fact be paying $20, $30 extra to go to the dump. That is a fact, isn't it? I mean, how do you think your dairy owners or your supporters would feel about that?
Look, I mean, for the Greens, you know, what I see is their supporters would be bitterly disappointed about this. The Greens are letting NZ First run the show and Labour take all the credit for all the Green initiatives. So I see the Greens are basically doing more damage to themselves, and they have nothing to show much about this one.
Walker jumping, Maxine, do you think, I mean, it's nobody can understand this legislation. I mean, it's Winston's thing, but the fact is, he could pull the whole thing down if they didn't support it. It means that much to him, doesn't it?
It's only here for such a temporary period of time. If that was the price that he extracted from either party to actually be in government, then following the next election, if New Zealand First don't get the votes, then any other party can make it, removing it, the price of their going into government. So I think we're sort of acting like this kind of walker-jumping legislation is going to be there for all time. It's there for the balance of this government. And I think the Greens are strong enough, and I think they are actually branding themselves enough in both areas, both the social justice areas with the Expert Welfare Advisory Group and in their environmental issues, that I think they're holding good ground.
Okay. If it means that they go against the fundamental things that they have always jumped up and down about, then what good is
but
that?
But you know how hard it is
to
distance yourself.
I do know.
The problem
exactly
for the Māori Party is that the tide went out just at the point
absolutely
when you guys were distancing
absolutely
yourselves.
Absolutely understand that completely, but we got the choice to vote with or against, and we used that choice and we voted with the government if we believed in it and against them when we didn't. Now, here's a bill. It might not mean anything, but what it means is a symbolic hamstringing of a party not to be independent in government.
Jennifer, do you think they need to? What do they need to do now in order to combat? You know, you've got the big bombastic New Zealand First grabbing headlines when they can. Labor trying to look green. What are the Greens going to do to make sure they can get above that 5%, get up towards 10% where they were?
Well, I don't think it's quite that straightforward, because no votes just go, you know, like this, backwards and forwards between Labor and the Greens. Really,
but what
Labor wanted,
from?
They need to get them back. So Labor needs to get them back from National,
yeah. Right.
And then
churn.
Yep. Yeah. So you take some back, but you do a centre-left government, you know, and you get win back from National. Meanwhile, you let the Greens take the left of the centre-left, and just do straightforward, you know, these are their policies. They can do welfare, they can be the conscience on welfare, on humanism, on ecologism, and the Labor can do pragmatic environmentalism, but also fiscal austerity.
They've got a bit of working out to do over the next week.
Yeah, but it'll
work. They hold the balance of power, but they choose not to wield it.
All right.